Welcome back to Learning How. Today we are learning about Jewel, Praying Wolf, Jade. He was born on February 2nd, 1953, and he is still alive today. He is 68 years old. James was born on the Lummi Indian Reservation in Western Washington. There's where he still lives today. He is a descendant of Chief Seattle. James is a master carver of the House of Tears, which is a group who wants to raise awareness of the need for healing within tribes, among races, and among nations. The House of Tears is known for sending totem poles to areas after natural disasters in hope of healing. James and the House of Tears are best known for carving the Lummi Healing Pole, which was carried to the Sterling Forest north of New York City to commemorate the victims of September 11, 2001. Many tribes sent healing blessings as the totem pole made its way across the country. The picture that we just saw is a totem pole that sits outside of the Pentagon. There are two 15-foot upright totem poles. The left one is known as Freedom. The right one is known as Liberty. They are carved by James and his House of Tear carvers. The Liberty pole features a female bear with a grandmother moon in her abdomen. The Freedom pole displays a male bear with a grandfather sun. The 34-foot sovereignty crossbar joining the two poles together displays eagles carved on each end. They also have two sets of seven feathers representing an American Airlines Flight 77 that crashed into the Pentagon on September 11th. The female eagle symbolizes peace and the male symbolizes war. The photo that we saw is courtesy of Jewel Praying Wolf James. In June of 2021, James and his House of Tear carvers presented the Biden administration with a totem pole. On the totem pole, he hoped to bring awareness to Indigenous people and their rights. Featured on the totem pole is a picture of a child in jail, which represents the children being jailed along the Mexican border. And so he hoped that through his totem pole that he could bring some rights to people that he feels are not being equally represented. For our Learning How today, we are gonna make our own totem poles. And so we're not gonna be carving, we are going to be creating stories, because that's essentially what the totem poles are representing. They are representing stories that are being told. So we are going to color on paper towel rolls, not toilet paper rolls, because I was thinking, I don't have any paper towel rolls at my house because I took all of our paper towel rolls to school. So I was like, what am I going to use as a display? So I do have a toilet paper roll that we've somehow managed to use up this week for my kids to show you. But we're going to use paper towel rolls, much larger, and we are going to create our own stories on our own totem poles. All right, James and Josiah are here to help us. We can only come up with one paper towel roll and one toilet paper roll this whole week. So, and I took the rest of them to school. So our class will have plenty because we've been saving for a long time for the class. But anyway, Jane, explain your totem pole to us. I'll do that. Okay, go ahead.
The beach, a Christmas tree, and
a toilet paper roll.
And then, so what does your totem pole represent? What story are you trying to tell?
Things
that you enjoy?
Mm-hmm.
Cool. Just that, where's yours? He's putting the finishing touches on his. All right, show them yours.
Hold on. 1 second.
And here is Josiah's totem pole. Okay, Josiah.
He's kind of like a poop dog.
Stop. What is yours representing?
A Christmas tree.
A Christmas tree. Do you enjoy decorating the Christmas tree?
Yes.
Yeah, so his represents us decorating our Christmas tree. We are Christmas. Decorations are already up.
Don't forget to hit that notification button, or you guys can hear our newest episodes. So stay tuned. See you guys later.
Bye.